Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Crazy Taxi 3. I'm CPC Gamer.
I'm CPC Sister the First.
Are you ready to see this game completely fall apart?
Yes.
This is a small apple. I occasionally equate it to being London, but it's meant to be New York.
Okay.
I can't do this one. I'm determined to show a bit of everything in this game, but I'm not very good at this.
Why?
The arrow lies to you.
How rude.
If you look at the West Coast and Glitter Oasis, they are basically a circuit.
Yeah.
There are some places where you can sort of shoot off to the left, like the library, but mostly it's a circuit. This is a grid, so the arrow doesn't know which is the most efficient way. So if you're trying to follow the arrow, occasionally it will say, no, make that left. Oh, okay.
Oh, it's like a sat-nav. Never trust a sat-nav.
You've seen the Brian Blessed voice of the sat-nav.
Yes. And I would get that for you if you ever had a car.
You get there and it goes, stop! It's great. And the music for this particular one is Japanese rock. I was going to use a really nifty font for it, but I couldn't, because this artist's name includes brackets.
Right.
Which the font included, so, yeah. That is what I get for picking music from an insane Japanese woman. Because aren't they all in my playlist?
I'm gonna say yes.
It's catchy, though.
Yeah. Probably not going to be singing it all day, though.
I don't know the lyrics. I know the bit that's in English which says, I love you, Fire Starman. That's that bit. otherwise, I have no idea what's going on. It's just really catchy and upbeat rock. I thought I was out of that. Oh, well.
Mind the truck.
I'll mind that truck.
Boxes!
There's your boxes! Yeah, something else that you can tell that this town was built for this game, because there are a lot of shortcuts that are just use the jump button.
I'll just jump over the shop. Don't mind me.
You can actually clear a bus. I tested it. Only on this map there's double-decker buses. And if you're going full speed towards them, you can't jump over them and clear them.
Can you do it in this video?
No. That was years ago when I was just playing this to screw around. I do this, though.
Woo! I like that. No.
If you're clever, you can clear the entire mall doing that. I didn't because I realized I was going the wrong way. Oh, dear. See, I think it's a vicious cycle. I get to this one and I go, well, I'm not very good at this. I'm going to go play West Coast again. And then I get even better at that.
Yeah.
And then I go, maybe I'll try Small Apple again. Oh, maybe not.
You should practice more.
I don't practice for these videos, I just... This is me picking it up after however long. I lied, this is my 7th take. I did 7 tries at this, and this is the best one.
Oh, Bella, let me
know. Okay.
Oh yeah, practice.
It is pronounced Deeth, apparently.
No, it's not.
That's what she says.
You can't have the same 2 letters and pronounce them in 2 different ways, says the English speaker.
How do you get a TH sound from DI colon bracket?
Have you ever seen Gaelic written down? It's a bit like that.
Does it use punctuation?
Yes. In the usual places, though.
Fun times. All right, then. Show me.
Not like that.
I'm glad that the physics doesn't quite behave itself in this game. Don't quite behave themselves? Oh, I don't know.
Anyway. The music hall.
The only thing I know about this is that I completely miss half of the map. But it transpires that the people all want to go to the same basic locations. So I don't get to go to the waterfront and show off the pier. Which is nice, because it's a really nice looking location for a like Xbox middle of the road title. It's happy and bouncy and I love it. You can't tell, but we're dancing away. I keep wanting to put in a face cam, but not really, because I think that's silly. It might be worth it to see some of your silly reactions to my silly edits. Or jumping into a canyon.
I don't
do you
know
see that? Do
calling.
You see what that arrow's doing?
Yes.
That is shenanigans.
Left. Right. No, left.
That's why I'm not keen on this one. It requires knowing what you're doing.
We're not good at that.
Although, with that said, there is a button push combination for the game that turns off either the arrow or that glowing green bin. Or both. If you so desire.
How do you know where you're going?
You just go with what the game says. I want to pick up those. We'll go for these WrestleMen. You'd think that I'd pick them up from the right side of the road, but but no.
Whee!
That's another reason I don't like the jump button in this game.
Do you have to be moving to jump? Boxes!
You don't have to be moving, but if you are moving forwards, you move forwards. You can't just hop.
Okay.
And I did some thinking. I can think of precisely two driving games, aside from this one, that have a jump button. What is this arrow doing?
Lying. Lying and lying.
There's Super Mario Kart. And then they got rid of that power-up because it was stupid. And the Streets of Sim City, which was a great game.
I miss that game. Was that the one you could drive through the city you built?
Yes.
I really miss that game.
It was a good game. But it is aggressively programmed to not run on anything beyond Windows 98, so...
Couldn't you jump in Ignition?
No. There are jumps in Ignition.
I miss that as well. I played that game far too much.
I really hope people have played Ignition. That was a really good game. It was by Virgin Interactive.
Really?
Yep. I don't know where we got it. It just came installed on our computer once. And it's still there, and we love it. Maybe. Also, I like how I picked up the same guys that just jumped out of my car.
Maybe they changed their mind.
Maybe if I'm going to be better off this time, because look. It's the gap. Product placement. You can kind of tell when each of these games is programmed, because if you notice, Blitzer Oasis doesn't have any. I guess they didn't have faith in Crazy Taxi 2. This is one of my favorite locations, if I can navigate it.
Shiny.
And it's an annoying thing, because all of those screens are active and moving, but you have to stop and watch them, which you can't really do in this game. And you know, now as I watch this back, if I just made that jump, that's twice now I could have made these drops. Oh well.
You still got speedy.
I did, so that's good. In the arcade mode, that matters. If you are speedy, you get a time bonus. But in this, it's just a measure of how well you do.
Was that the UPS drop?
I wouldn't have thought so. Because otherwise it'd be a UPS store in the game. It's probably something like generic juice truck. Or something like that. That actually worked out quite well. That's how to do good cornering.
Just crouch.
The walls are there to cushion you, right?
Always.
I think the reason I'm crashing so much is because I'm habitually driving on the left.
Just happens. Because we do it right.
And everyone else is wrong.
The entire world.
Except for Japan.
Oh, what just happened?
I don't know! That's me trying to auto-correct for the arrow, which is auto-correcting for me. And it just created a recursive loop. That was weird.
It's not a drop off until you hit the shrubbery.
Oh, absolutely. The weird JPEG shrubbery. I thought we'd outgrown that sort of thing, video games.
Never.
I want to say FAO Schwartz is a thing as well. Like, that's an actual place, not a... Because that sounds really specific. It would otherwise say, like, oh, the food shop or whatever, right? I don't know.
Shop at generic cheap supermarket.
Me too. And usually you can't tell. Oh, got some popping suspension. Oh, this is a fun one. So I've been driving around it, but I'm guessing that is some approximation of Central Park. You can actually go inside it, and there are three separate drops in here, and that's one of them. Oh, also, as you've seen, the game doesn't much care for physics, so you can drive underwater. There are people waiting underwater as well. They usually have really long, obscure requests.
I want to see.
I didn't show that off.
Why not? Let's do this again.
Something I'm sad that I didn't show off is it's possible to sort of wedge your car into a wall sideways. And because you're on two wheels, the game thinks you're drifting. So you can just park there for about 20 seconds, drifting, not doing anything. Mind the traffic on the busy road. Ah, how dare they.
Get out of the way.
I've never been to New York, so again, I assume this is what it's like. Just taxis flying all over the place and...
It's probably completely accurate. Are you not getting the 4-drop with 55 seconds left?
I'm not going to get that 4-drop with 55 seconds left, no.
No sense of adventure.
I know better than that. Oh, no, that's not the way.
The wall you can't go through?
There's two separate ways to go through this. You can make a right into an underpass. And I forget where that takes you. I think it's the bandstand. Look, it's HMV!
I know that.
Just to really date the video. Although that doesn't exist in America.
Oh.
So it's just called Guitar Shop in America. And I know that because I looked up a... Oh, you see the... You can just about see the signs at the top of the screen there. The little guy dancing. I looked up the ideal route for the every stop challenge. And it threw me because it said, okay, now make a stop at the guitar shop. But I couldn't find that. I could only find HMV.
But they don't sell guitars.
They don't. So presumably they reskinned it. Oh, and while we're here, before the video ends, the parking garages are a lie in this game. They lead you underground, but they're a dead end. That is not a good thing to put in a game where you have to drive around the city.
No. Class S license.
But I still got a Class S license, so that will do me.
I don't know what that means.
It's pretty good.
Okay. Yay!
Okay, join us next time for a little bit more Crazy Taxi. And until next time, goodbye!
Bye.